Hello, welcome to C programming. In this video we will see how to use break and continue statements. Break and continue statements are used within a loop. Here we have a program. Let us work on this program. At the top you can see I have included the standard header files stdio.h and conio.h. These header files are mandatory in almost our programs because we are using printfscanf, and printfscanf is defined in stdio.h and getch, clrscr, those definitions are given in conio.h. Here we have a variable declared, n, and the function clrscr is given to clear the screen. And we can have a loop here, let it be a do loop. So do loop is starting and ending, you can see it. Do loop in the sense do while loop. So do while loop is an, that is, in the while we have a condition given, so that condition decides when to exit from the loop. So whether the condition is true or not, the program flow will enter into the loop at least once. Rest depends on the condition given in the while. Exit control loop. The checking is done at the exit point. The loop will continue till the value of n equal to 0. It will continue till n not equal to 0. So that is the condition given with the while. Inside the loop you can see the very first statement is a scanf and printf combination, and printf is saying enter a number and scanf is for reading that number, and the value will be read into n, the variable n. After that you can see an if statement given, and in that if a condition is checked, the condition is n less than 0, then break. So the program is supposed to do some action break if the value entered by the user is n. Break in the sense it will exit out of the loop. Loop will not continue. And one more if statement is given, which is checking n is greater than 10. And if n is greater than 10, do some action. It is printing something, skip the value, whatever it is. And then it is given continue. Continue in the sense if the continue statement is given, if it is executed, it will go to the beginning of the loop without executing the rest part of the loop. That means there is one more statement given there, printf, the number is whatever. So without executing that particular printf, it will go back to the loop, do loop, beginning of the do loop again. That means the value entered by the user, if it is not less than 0, that means greater than or equal to 0, and not greater than 10, that is 10 or less than 10, that means in between 0 and 10, the values are from 0 to 10, then this printf statement will execute, the last printf statement, the one which is given above the while loop, while statement, the number entered is, that will be executed only if the number is between 0 till 10. If it is less than 0, then break and it will go back. If it is greater than 10, then it will print, skip the number, because of continue given there. And if it is less than 0, the break statement will execute and it will go back to the beginning of the loop. And of course you have to try this program in your system and verify it in your Turbo C++ or some other C compiler. And I hope you understood the use of break and continue in a loop. So this is applicable for other loops as well. While loop or for loop, you can use break or continue or both together according to your application. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe the channel for watching more videos. Bye.